With the divider, you can divide widgets horizontally or also vertically, and we will look at both examples, and we will also look at some other examples so that you can use different themes for your dividers, so you don't need to write your whole divider code many times. Let's get started with this example here on the right side. So we have no dividers at all. And here we have every time this item, this build month, and then we have here this other build item, build month. And between we want first of all to put a divider. And this is pretty simple. You simply go here between those both items and put a divider inside. And if you do this, it looks like this. And you see here a really thin divider. And we want to change here first of all the color of this divider so you can see it better. And you can also set here other properties inside. So first of all, you can set the indent, which is the spacing here on the left side. And if I hot reload, you see that we have here more spacing on the left side. And you can also put here the end indent inside. And then you have here the spacing on the right side. And you can also increase these both things. So for example, if you put here 40 inside, then you see that we have here more spacing, obviously. Then we can also add here a height, and there you can put a number, for example, like 40 inside, and then we have here a higher height of this divider, and now it's 40 pixels, and you can also increase this height, and this height will then be distributed equally to the top and also to the bottom of this divider. To change the line thickness, you have here this thickness parameter inside, and when you set a higher value inside, then it is changing the thickness, and I can even increase it. You can even set here like 0.5 inside, and then you have something like this line, or even you can go here below it, and then you have different kind of lines, and obviously you can also change your color, and then the color of this line will also change. Alright, this was right now everything about the horizontal line, and we can also do this with the vertical line. So I simply copy this here right now, and then I go here into our build month, and here we have these two widgets, and here between these two widgets we can add a divider, and if I now hot reload, you see there is no divider in between. So what we need to do here is to set the vertical divider instead, because we want to add a vertical divider. And instead of the height property, we have now here the width property, and everything is the same like the divider before. And now if I hot reload, you also see not the divider, and because the divider doesn't have here any height right now. And to show this divider, we need to go here to this row where our divider is inside and also the other objects. And here we wrap this row inside of an intrinsic height. And now if I hot reload, you see that we have here this vertical line inside. And you can also basically change here again the thickness so you see it here much more clear. And you can also again set here the indent to some value, for example 10, and also here to 10. And then you have here more space on the top and more space on the bottom. Alright, now we got to know how we can add horizontal dividers and also vertical dividers. However, you don't want to put here every time all this information inside and copy and paste it to all the locations where you need a divider. So we want to use here some theming, and therefore you can simply copy this here, and here you can create a new file and call it, for example, basic theme. And here inside of this class, you create a new method and call it, for example, theme. And you also need to put here the context inside, and then you create here a new theme data. And here we can define the divider theme. So we define here how our dividers should look like. And here you simply create this object, divider theme data, and paste all the things inside which we have copied before. And instead of this width, you need to define here another one, which is called space. And now we can use this basic theme, which we have created here, and can put it to all the locations where we use a divider. So instead of putting here all this information inside, I will remove this again. And now if I hot reload, it looks like there are almost no divider inside. And now we can use this theme, so we go here some bit higher, and then we go here to this build basic divider, which is exactly this page here. for this page, because we have also later different pages, and there you can also use a different seam of your divider. And what we are doing here is to basically wrap this around with the seam object, and here inside you can supply a data, and here we want to put the basic seam inside. So I simply write here basic seam and seam and put also the context inside. And now if we hot restart, we get again here this divider back, and for all the locations, and you don't need to define it then here inside, because all this divider thing is already defined here inside. And we could also do this same thing with the other divider. So we have here built in the beginning this horizontal divider, which you see here. And instead of putting here all the information inside, we can simply delete it. And now if I hot reload, we have here exactly this divider of our seam, and everything is defined here. And if you want to change here something, then you simply change it at one location and all the dividers will also change. And you can also change here, for example, the color to another color, and automatically everything will change here. And right now this affects only this page here, because we have here also another page, and here we have some divider inside, and this one is not affected. If you want to have only one seam in your whole application, you can also go here to the top and go into your seam data, and then you simply put this divider seam there inside. So you can paste it here inside. And now if I hot reload, you see also that it is here on the second page, and we also don't need this basic seam anymore. However, if you have different dividers for many pages, then you can basically create for every page a different seam. And then you simply wrap here around your page this new seam object, which you want to use for this page. Let's also quickly look here at the last case, this horizontal divider. So we have here these items, and instead of this list view builder, you can every time use the list view separated. And then you get here this field separator builder, and here inside you can put your divider inside. And now if I put here simply this divider inside, you don't see here anything, because here we have set the axis to horizontal, and therefore we need to set here a vertical divider inside. And now you see here this divider inside, and we also get it from our seam, because right now he is using the seam here at the top of our application. So he is taking our main seam, and you can also change here then again the colors, and you see that it is also changing the colors here. And to make this divider working, I simply changed here right now something, because this is how it looks normally in your list view if you have a horizontal list view, and here you have all your items, and then we have here this vertical divider inside. However, you also need to wrap your list view, which is separated, inside of another container, and here you can set the height of this list view. And if we do this, then you see something like this. And now you simply can change here this height of this list view, and then the divider will also be like 300 pixels right now. And by the way, if you want to get the source code of this example, you can get it with the first link in the description, and with the second link you can get my Flutter course, where I teach you how you can become a more efficient Flutter developer.
Hello everyone, thank you so much for watching this video. Please make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel here to get the latest news about Flutter, and see you soon, bye!